Hebrews chapter 7 and verse 14. Let's see why our Lord and Savior and what tribe he came out of. Hebrews chapter 7 and verse 14. We're going to read one verse here. Hebrews chapter 7 and verse 14. Go ahead.
For it is evident that our Lord sprang out of Judah, of which tribe Moses spake nothing concerning priesthood.
So where did tribe Jesus came from?
Judah.
What tribe did Muhammad come from?
Ishmael
or Koresh. That's the other 12 princes that God gave Muhammad, Ishmael. He's not of the nation of Israel. He's not. Jesus said, God said, our Lord and Savior gonna come out of Judah, which is the 12 tribes of Israel from Jacob. Let's see what this Jesus, our Lord and Savior, gonna do for us if we follow him. Let's go to Isaiah chapter 9. It's very important that you know this. Very important. Like I said, it's been 2 years ago since I done this message. Take time to study this. I know there's a lot of information that we cover. There's a lot on your plate. You can't go to a buffet and get everything. So you take a little bit that you understand and you build on it. That's all you can do. You build on it. Take this little bit. Don't get intimidated by this because I'm still learning. Let's see what, if we follow Jesus, what he's going to do for us and where his kingdom is going to be. Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6. Go ahead, brother.
For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given.
Yes, sir.
And the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful.
Yes, sir.
Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace.
This son right here is very powerful, ain't it? Very powerful. But Muhammad said he's a messenger. He's simple. He's just like me. Farah Muhammad. This is the thing that's going on today, man. You got to understand, Jesus is very important. And we used to talk about the nation of Israel. They think we don't believe in Jesus. The ones over there in the land in Israel today, they do not believe in Jesus. Period. The Jewish people, they do not. You go over there and tell them about Jesus, they say, we don't care about your black Jesus. And they know he's black. They know it. He said a government shall sit upon his shoulder. He said he's going to set up his kingdom upon where? Earth. Let's show you the key reading.
Of the increase of his government and peace there shall be no end.
Yes,
upon
sir.
The throne of David and upon his kingdom to order it.
Yes, sir.
And to establish it with judgment and with justice from henceforth, even forever.
He said, I'm going to establish this kingdom upon the throne of David. Where was David's throne?
On
earth in Jerusalem.
That's right.
But what did the people inside the church tell you? We're going to heaven. We're going on by. Going up and young. This is what they tell us. But Jesus is saying he's going to establish his throne on the throne of David. Every throne ain't never been in heaven with God. Go ahead, bro. Yes, sir.
The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this.
Yes, sir.
Verse 8. The Lord sent a word into Jacob, and it has lightened upon Israel.
The Lord sent a word unto who?
Jacob,
which is Israel. This is how you gonna know, this is how you're gonna get salvation. Period. If you listen to folks that tell you that my mama died, she looking down for me, man, she's alive. She following somebody else. She ain't following this God. Let me show you where this throne will be located. Let's let the angel tell Mary before Jesus was born. Let's go to Luke chapter 1, verse 30. This gonna be the last one. Luke chapter 1, verse 30. We just trying to build, man. We got a lot of time on this earth to finish this. We ain't gonna finish it all. Luke chapter 1, we're gonna start at verse 30. You think there's somebody else that's going to save you besides Jesus? You've been listening to a whole bunch of lies. If your pastor said he's going to heaven, he's a thief and a robber. If he tell you that the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, the Louis Farrakhan, is our messenger, he's a liar and a thief. Run! Get away from him.
Amen.
Get away from him. Verse 30, go ahead.
And the angel said unto her, Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God.
He said, the angel said to her, Fear not, Mary, because you have found favor with God. Because and she was a virgin when she had Jesus. And these people do not believe in that, especially Muhammad people. They think that's Joseph's kid. Go ahead.
And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb, and bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus.
Yes, sir. Let's see what he's going to do. Let's see what Jesus is going to do. Go ahead.
He shall be great.
Mm-hmm.
Shall be called the Son of the Highest.
Mm-hmm.
And the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David.
Where is David's throne?
On earth.
On earth. In Jerusalem. Go ahead.
And he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever. And of his kingdom there shall be no end.
There shall be no end. Where is Elijah at? Mm-hmm. Elijah Muhammad. In the grave. He right there. We looking for the Son, which is Christ, to come and save us. So don't get caught up on these black activist groups now. Because you end up in yourself and you end up in your family. But I hope you understand this lesson about Jesus or Muhammad. Take this. Be it on. Go do your own research. It'll show you. You're going to stand and close out.